Yeah, nah, I wouldn't call them my boys, you know. Yeah. I'd call them my fam, you know, because, like, one of them is my brother, it's my big brother, you know, and the other's just a friend of my brother. So, obviously, we built a relationship, you know, the three of us. And they actually made free beats for me up in PTA, and they don't do that, you know, especially for a 16-year-old rapper. Yeah. So, yeah, it is what it is.
Nah, that's it's a good song, right? I want to know, why start a beef? Why not talk about this man to man, you know?
I don't see it as beef, you know.
Word.
I see it as a soliloquy, like, you know, man, I mean, rap is about expression, right?
Word, yeah.
So I was expressing myself, simple as, I mean, I had to download the beat, I don't even have.
Yeah. Oh, so that's not your beat?
Yeah, that's not my beat.
Oh, you downloaded it?
Yeah.
Ah,
so have you got any sort of response from Casper?
So we were looking for a name and I was so fascinated by star signs, you know, stuff like that. He put me on anyway, so yeah, man, and he was like, why don't we do something that incorporates your star sign? Because you're so fascinated with your star sign. I'm an Aries. So, you know, and then we started playing with it. He started calling it Air-Reece, like Airs. And then it didn't make sense though. So I was like, how about we say A-Reece and then give every letter a significant term? You know what I mean? So A stands for above, and then the R stands for reality. So it's above reality. Exceptionally emotional, conscious with everything. Hip-hop to me means doing you on wax. So basically I'm saying hip-hop to me is where you put all your emotions on wax however you decide to. It felt right because it's, you know, something that I've always wanted to happen. I mean, you know when you're good at what you do. To all my fans, I love you and I will love you until I die. But fortunately, I will never, because you have this music and this music is gonna live forever. So, shut up.
Yo, okay. So, we out at Headfield Shisenyama, right? Mm-hmm. To show everyone's happy, we're performing, we get in love, we show in love. It's after the show and look, you know how it goes, Pearl, you know, we're rappers. There's a lot of beautiful girls in the event, there's drinks. We're probably not going straight home. Hey, you wanna join us? You know? So there were these other girls, right? They got in the H1, and then this dude pulled up. He's like, yo, get out of that car. Get out, let's go home, let's go. You know, but the girl doesn't really want it. Like, she's like, I'm rolling with these dudes, not you.
Over for you.
So the dude's like, yo, grabs her by the wrist, you know, actually pulls her out the car on some crazy dreading scene type-ish, you know. The girl comes out the car, she's crying, you know how it is, you know. He actually like, yo, grabs her face, tries to lift it up, like, yo, hey, I'm telling you right now, we need to leave. He starts becoming physical a little bit, so everybody's just like, whoa, hey, yo, we gonna let this dude do this? So we first, like, you know, get him away from the girl. Like, yo, man, back off. But I guess he was intoxicated. So he fought back and we all just fought. And look, we beat him up.
So I came here to South Africa instead of him flying to New York so we could bring it. Hey, Reese, where you at, baby? Reese, man, you remember how we first communicated?
I do.
What did you say to me, man?
I dropped like 5 caskets on you.
What did that mean exactly?
I mean, only dead bodies going to like a casket, you know?
Security!
I mean, it's very important. It's unfortunately, it's part of the business, you know what I mean? It's part of the music business. There's the phase where you get into making the music and everything is dope and everything is fun and you're making music with your friends in your bedroom studio, to where it becomes more professional when you have to be recording in the studio when you're making an album and you have to make sure everyone gets a split in their publishing and you have to make sure that the producer is paid and the artist is, you know what I mean? Like, so it's very important for artists to do their research if they really want to get into this industry and do it professionally. You know, because a lot of people don't talk about that. They don't know that you know, this hip-hop shit, this rap shit is like a sport, man. You know what I mean? We should be in the Olympics because we're professionals. You know what I mean? There's the ones that just do it to do it, and there's us. You know what I mean? The professionals. So they need, it's important for youngsters to do their research, and before getting into it, just make sure that you know what you're doing. And you don't have to go independent. As long as you get a deal that's like suitable for you, and you know the terms are more, you know, are more like you're on your side, then you can do what you want to do, man. I mean, do the right thing. Don't just, you know, do the right thing and learn from us. Learn from the people that had to, you know, that had to get the arrows in their backs so that they could sacrifice for the next generation, you know what I mean? The ones that did it wrong and had to get it right along the way. Just learn from that, you know what I mean? And just believe in yourself and be consistent at the end of the day. You know, Coca-Cola still advertises their product till this day. So that should tell you something.
I feel like at a point in the future, kids are gonna be sampling us. Sampling what we do right now. I feel like maybe it's giving the youth some knowledge on the old music, because they get to appreciate the creation of it all. They get to look back and be like, okay, this song came out in the 70s and it's still being used on a hip-hop beat, and that's longevity. So I guess it kind of like maybe sheds a little light on how dope the music back then was.
Great.
Who's joining me?
Does he know the rules?
Let's go, bro.
One, go.
Come on, my boy. All right, that's something.
Done.
No way, bro.
Nah, dog. Just continue.
Give me a second, y'all.
Yeah, you just continue, bro.
Just give me a second, y'all. I got it. I'm just trying to. It's a little bit of done.
It's the fastest.
But that's like 60%. This is probably the fastest joint I've ever rode.
That's like, yeah.
But I can see why it looked like that. I don't feel like going out to mend things with anybody. I feel like I'm in a great space, like. So I don't feel like I'm obliged to make anything work. I mean, if things should work, then fuck it, the Murphy's Law, man. What happens, happens. Though she would tell me that I need to study off the matric, you know, she never really told me to stop rapping or it's bad for me, you know. She actually encouraged me to write more and write about things that, you know, mean something to me, not just write just to rap. So that played a huge role because I'm very conscious in what I pen down till this day. Me and my father, I love my father, man. Like, my father would always come back from work, tell me to get in the Benz, and then we'd ride like around the whole neighborhood, and he'd tell me, yo, play that hip hop, play those songs you like playing, you know what I mean? Like, play that, and then I'd play that shit. This nigga would turn the volume all the way up, open up all the windows, you know what I mean? And let me feel comfortable in that space. So I always appreciate my father for that. I used to play a lot of Pac in that shit.
It's all good. I think I'm also gonna pop up. There's a van store down the road. Should we go there?
Yeah, we can scoop through.
All right, before we leave, you heard it from the man himself. We just found out everything about his love for sneakers, his relationship with sneakers, and how it links to the man and his music, right?
Yes, sir.
And you heard
yes,
it from
sir.
The horse's mouth himself.
Gee.
We are.